So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel again, and here I have come with another video, another interview experience, or some various informative topics about Amul, obviously. So to discuss about all these things, I have a guest tonight, and here this is my friend Shupratim Nondi, and he is my batchmate from NIT Agartala. Obviously, he was in computer science and engineering department, and after that he had done his MBA, and right now he is working in Amul. So he would be the best person, I guess, so to discuss about all these things. So let's welcome him. Hello, Shupratim.
Okay, so as you already know that I've done my engineering from NIT Agartala, as he's already told. After that, during my final year, I started my preparation for MBA. And in my first job itself, I went to one of the premium rural management institute in this country, known as IRMA. Its full form is Institute of Rural Management Anand. It's in Gujarat. Most of you know Anand for Amul, where the plant Kaira Union is situated. At Amul, I have been to various competitions, won around 8 to 9 marketing competitions. My domain was basically rural marketing, and after which I sit for placements. Both my summer internship was in Amul, and also that time I did not get a PPO, but then I again sat for Amul during my final placements, and in the first shot itself I cleared Amul, and here I am. I'm posted in Silchar right now, handling over the entire Barak Valley and Mizoram territory for Amul products, proper distribution in these areas.
So let's discuss about your interview experiences. As it is an on-campus recruitment, so can you please share about your experience, that what is the campus recruitment culture there, and what you have faced, what you have gone through?
So one thing that I would be tell to the viewers, which they should be very clear about, is that you always have a locational advantage. So always play your locational advantage in the right way. Like if you are from Northeast, play your vocational strength, because you know your demography very well. So know one thing, that people from Northeast especially, or people from a particular domain, know their territory very well. So most of the management recruitees in Amul are being recruited in sales and marketing field. So marketing, okay, it's a different ball game altogether, but in case of sales, they would always want people with core competencies and who know the territory very well. So for example, if you're a guy from Northeast, so they would like to place you in Northeast because you know your demography well, you know how to handle people there, you know about the culture, the food habitat, the socio-economic environment of the place. So they would always want to place you there. So when I applied for Amul, my prime focus was that I should be in Northeast, also because I wanted to be in Northeast. One, that a company like Amul, associated with a company like Amul, is a big privilege for me. And then number two is that coming to Northeast is also another privilege, because I can work for my people here, ensure proper distribution of the dairy products of one of the biggest companies in this country. So yeah, so that was all in my mind. So when I applied for Amul, the first step is of course through the form filling, where I was asked which should be the locations where I should go. So my first choice was Northeast, number two was West Bengal, of course due to language preferences, and the third choice was Mumbai, because I've done my internship in Mumbai. So Mumbai was also the work culture that I've also been accustomed to. Next comes number two, where your first level of interview is taken by general managers or deputy managers of the company. This is mostly about your subject oriented, like accounts, what you have studied, marketing management, what you have studied, about various management subjects, what you have studied. You are judged on your academics, and that is what they want to do. Basically, they want to test whether academically you are skillful or not. What are your pointers? How are you? How have you performed? Are you a bright student? Can you give the company the kind of atmosphere that it wants? Are you right fit for the organization? One thing that has to be made very clear is that any company does not search for the best or the perfect person in the interview. What they search in an interview is the right fit for the organization. It might not be the person who has the best pointers, or might be, for example, in my case, the person who was a topper was being rejected in Amul. So there's nothing like that. Even if the interview goes well, they assess you whether you might be the best person, but are you a good fit for the organization or not. Now, what are the criteria is something that the upper management understands. The second level of interviews with the upper management itself, where the MD and the other MD, the CEO and other people come, the senior managers, and they try to assess you on various parameters, on your skills, on your experience, on how for example, I was being asked to sell a particular lassi in front of them. So they try your sales and marketing skills, how you try to assess yourself. So from 250 people in the first round, it came down to 40 people in the second round. So around 210 people were being rejected, right? And in the next round of 40 people, again, out of them, only 17 people were selected, including boys and girls altogether, and also the PRMX students altogether, the executive students. So that is where your street life, your street skills, your smart skills come into play, because they see how smart you are in terms of selling a product, in terms of asserting yourself. If you are not confident about yourself, then the management, how will they be confident about giving you a job, right? So that's how it goes. And then I secured my job. I was given a sales position here in Silchar, and I'm handling it. My main criteria here is channel management, where I hold and manage the distributors here, ensure proper distribution of products and proper servicing of retail outlets, MFS stores, APOs, etc.
What you are working on, Propel, means what? If I talk about the work culture in Amul, so can you share about your experience on that?
See, in Amul, one thing is very nice. People respect you very much. The reason is that it's not only people inside the company, but outside the company too. You are associated with a brand which is seen to be pure in this country. Like, you know, there is a brand image always plays a big role.
Yeah. Right?
So I can also, for example, I'm sorry to say this, but I can also work in a liquor company, which will provide me more salary than what Amul pays me. But then it won't fetch me the respect that it fetches me when I work in the market, or when I go to meet some distributor or a hotel person for that matter, because everybody respects you. One thing that I found good is that whether it's the police commissioner, whether it's the local authorities, whether it's the distributor, whether it's the hoteliers, whether it's any place for that matter, when you take Amul's name, doors open for you. So it enjoys good brand equity. At least in Northeast, it enjoys very good brand equity in terms of the brand faith, for that matter. And of course, being associated with Amul is also a lot of respectful job, because you are paying back to the farmers of this country. It's a cooperative and not a private company.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you're paying back to the farmers. 80% of what we earn is going to the farmers. And who could imagine that a company which is cooperative and not even a private limited could one day be a company which is aiming towards 50,000 crores in the next financial year? So, you know, I mean, a company which is giving tough fight to companies like Nestle, we've already left behind Britannia a long way. And now the target is Nestle. So if you are competing with companies like Nestle and ITC and even defeating them at certain points, once Quality Walls would have been the best ice cream in the country. But now today, in terms of Northeast and the entire country, we have left behind Quality One. We are number one in ice cream today. So we did not know that a few years back that we would be achieving this feat. We are the only company in this COVID times which ensured a growth of 2%. A positive growth of 2% in the COVID time. So our distribution business has gone really well. In terms of work culture inside the company, you have a lot of respect. Yes, it's a sales job, so pressure is always there, right? And you would have to meet your targets, or you would have to see the distribution going on. But yeah, one thing is that I would say that in Amul, one thing that I sleep well at night thinking that I did not do anything unethical in the day, right? So the company is very much ethical with its policies. And everybody's providing with right respect. Nobody pushes you for targets and stuff. People just tell you that this is what you have to achieve. If you don't achieve it, you give a proper reason for not the market not responding in the way you have decided. And everybody listens to you properly. Nobody just forces you on something.
Yeah. Correct. So I would like to know about another thing that means what kind of specializations do actually Amul recruit? Means if anyone wants to work in this kind of company like Amul, so what are the things they should do in their MBA, or what are the specializations they should approach? So please tell me about that one.
Basically, see, Amul has a sales job, marketing job, accounts, or factory. So if you want to work in factory, simply engineering in production from good colleges like NITs or IITs is enough to enter Amul Fed or Amul production factories, right? The union factories. At present, we have 18 milk unions factories which produce cheese, butter, every other product, Amul Cool and all these products, right? And in terms of sales job, the sales job is basically channel management. By channel management, I mean managing distributors, managing hotels, Horeca segment, managing the inflow of cash from the market, outflow of products to the market, and timely availability. So we say the three A's are very important: availability, accessibility, and the last A is probably another stress on availability, because we want to increase the frequency of products in the market. right? So that's there. Now, in terms of marketing, you can do an MBA in marketing. Mostly, it can be in marketing, it can be in campaign designing, it can be in advertising, it can be from institutes like MICA or IIMs or NMIMS or all these things. Or in some cases, you can also shift internally, switch to marketing after even after being doing the rural management from IRMA or TIS or all these colleges. One thing about Amul is that no lateral placements are allowed. So you have to get placed in Amul from your college itself. So they only recruit from IIMs or IRMA or TIS or such big colleges. They don't recruit from any other college. So if you want to enter and anyhow other than these colleges, it's not allowed. Matlab, they won't take you in.
They won't allow off-campus placements also, or only on campus they recruit?
No, they won't allow off-campus placements. No lateral entries are allowed.
So after end of the everything means, what would you like to suggest to the MBA graduates right now who are doing their MBAs if they want to pursue their career in Amul? So means there is any internship opportunity, or means they should directly focus on the placements and the company history, I guess? What
See, would you advise? Of course, you do your internship. Internships are very important. Summer internships are very important. They form your base for what you present at yourself in the final placements, because most of the people doing MBA today are freshers. That the statistics says that. So they don't have any idea about market working. So when you do your summer internship segment with Amul or any other company, only then you know how to behave in a sales organization or a distribution organization. And then you present your experiences in front of people who come to take your interview in the final placement. And then that is very, 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 very much essential. But one thing I would like to say to people who are doing MBA right now, see, MBA right now is becoming very common. If you're not doing MBA from the top 20 or top 20 colleges, it is going to be very hard. So what if you're not doing it from the
competition from the right is colleges? Very what, high. That it is.
Yeah. What if you're not doing it? Life does not end there. Build yourself in such a way that you have some extracurricular. By extracurricular, I mean extracurricular things in marketing. So, for example, you go to Udemy or other websites and try to get a certification on Google AdWords. Try to get a certification on SEO, search engine optimization, digital marketing, or for that matter, you try take certifications like CISA certifications. You take financial accounting certifications along with your MBA, so that it boosts your CV very much, right? And of course, internships help. So keep on doing the internships as much as you can. These are hard times, as we know, but then I don't think that private companies would not go for real talents and would only ask for degrees. So if you're even getting a degree from, first of all, you should not do MBA from, if you're not doing it from top 20 colleges right now. And if you do it, if you are hell-bent on doing it and not waiting one more year, then I would say build your CV in such a way that you have your extracurricular merits mentioned on the CV, so that all these organizations have an interest, develop an interest in you, because you need to have something from the people who are doing it from the top-notch colleges, so that you can also present themselves in the same line.
Okay, so it was really a nice discussion, Shubhpratim. Thank you so much for sharing such informative things to all of us. So I hope the viewers would be very much benefited by this video. And guys, if you really like this video, so please hit the thumb button and as usual, please do the subscribe button also and press the bell icon so that every video could be reached to you, and share this video with your friends who are doing MBAs in different colleges. I hope his advices would be very much beneficial to all. So all the best to you all, and thank you so much for watching videos. See you on the next video.